are having the Community Health Coalition annual meeting, which is about the 29th year in existence. This year, mental health is the theme because the community wanted to know more about mental health, and we think mind, body, and spirit go together. So we're setting up now for a free dinner to the public, and outside we have screening, blood pressure, glucoses, depression scores, and risk factors for cardiovascular disease. This is our board member, and she can tell you a little bit of what she's doing to volunteer or to help.
Well, I'm Dr. Jamila Minga, and it is always an honor to work next to Dr. Hart Brothers and what she's doing in the community and advocating for the community, and particularly mental health. And I am just here volunteering my time to administer surveys this afternoon.
Thank you.
There's another active member in the community. I'm Dr. Hart Brothers, so yeah. I founded the Community Health Coalition. Mm-hmm. And we work with other organizations. Mm-hmm. And so we're so happy to have them starting to join us. And you can introduce yourself.
I'm Jan Cromarty from a health chair at the Durham Committee on the Affairs of Black People. With this lady's assistant, I had a fine Unity Community, Durham Community Health Fair last year, speaking about health care reform and opioid epidemic.
There we go. Yeah. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Crystal Horton, and I'm a nurse. I work for North Carolina Baptist on Mission. So we are a faith-based organization out of Cary, North Carolina, and you know us mostly for disaster relief. So if there's ever a catastrophe or a disaster nationally, internationally, you'll see our volunteers going out with the yellow shirts on that are helping clean up and helping with feeding teams, laundry teams, things like that. But we also not only do disaster relief, we also have a dental bus and we also have a health screening bus. And so we take those throughout the state of North Carolina and offer free preventative screenings for patients that may not otherwise be getting screened for things such as diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, depression, heart disease, risk assessment. We just got new eye screening equipment, which I'm really excited about. So we're able to do a full basic health assessment on patients that may not otherwise be able to get screened. On the dental bus ministry, we're able to do free extractions and free fillings for those patients. And so the only thing that we ask is that we get invited by local churches, community organizations. They invite us in and they help us get the volunteers needed to staff the unit. So today we have lots of students from Winston-Salem State's nursing program, and we also have some volunteers from Duke that are out helping us today. So we're really excited when we get lots of volunteers to come out and help us with this.
Thank you.
I'm Charla, and this is Jackie, and we're from Counter Tools in Carver, North Carolina, and we're here to educate people about point-of-sale tobacco. One of the things that we're noticing at the point-of-sale are more e-cigarettes, especially amongst youth and lower-income populations being used. And one of the more popular products is the Juul, and it has currently half the market share. And so in our office, we sometimes look to buy starter kits or look to see what types of products are on the market. And this one is a starter kit, so it comes with four different pods. So there's nice flavors that could be really enticing to kids, such as mango, creme brulee, menthol, so forth. And you can see this is the device itself. It looks like a USB, so it's been kind of concealed a lot of times in classroom settings because it does look like a USB.
So the thing with these e-cigarettes, so most e-cigarettes come with a liquid, they call it an e-liquid or an e-juice. This one is, Juul calls it pods, but the same idea. And in these e-liquids, e-juices, or pods, contains nicotines, and it also contains a bunch of different harmful chemicals. There's been multiple studies done that have shown there's volatile compounds, there's metals, there's lead, there's things that cause cancer in these e-juices. juices and flavor pods. So even though you might think, it's just water vapor, it's just, you know, you're just blowing out just air, you're really blowing out a bunch of different horrible things that are horrible for your health.
How can people learn more about what you do?
You can go to our website. So we have two different websites. If you want to learn more about Counter Tools, the consulting organization, that's countertools.org. If you want to learn about our project called Counter Tobacco that has lots of free different resources on it, you can go to countertobacco.org.